snatch it back and hold it, baby, one more time.
I know in the last video I said it was going to be the last one in the Getting Started series. Now, turns out I was wrong about that. This will be a short one. I just want to go over two things. One is I want to redo the short of how to keep your pedal LEDs in sync with your virtual pedals, which is the same as instead of turning bypass on and off, you turn the pedal on and off. And then the second thing I want to do is I want to go over model presets. Model presets are different than the presets we've talked about before. So you want to stick around for that. All right, let's get started. I was editing the closed captioning for the last video when I heard myself say, changing min and max for on-off buttons doesn't do much. And I thought, that's probably not true. One thing used to bug me about AmpliTube that I've since gotten used to is when I step on my effects pedal to turn on an effect, the virtual pedal lights up in AmpliTube, but the LED on my pedal goes off. I know what I'm programming with the pedal is to turn bypass on, so while I didn't like the behavior, it made sense to me. With min and max, I can fix this. I can just set min to 100% and max to 0%. Now, stepping on my pedal is turning the pedal on and off instead of turning the bypass mode on and off. That's much better. Model presets work in multiple places, so you can use them with areas like amps, cabinets, and rack effects. You can right-click on an amp face and a context menu shows up. Currently, the options are to save a preset, load a preset, or copy the settings. Let's save our current settings. I've already saved multiple settings for this amp, but the first time I did it, AmpliTube automatically created a folder for me based on the amp I was using. This folder is located under your user home folder, Documents, IK Multimedia, AmpliTube 5, Models. Give your preset a name and click Save. Now, whenever you want everything else in your overall preset to stay the same, but you want new settings for the amp, just use Load Model Preset and pick on one of your saved settings. If you want to use the current settings in another preset, you can copy settings from here and paste them over the amp or pedal effect in your target preset. Notice that part of the settings will be the amp or effect itself, and if your amp head was linked to a cabinet, that's going to come over as well. If you want the amp but not the cabinet, remember to unlink the cabinet first and then save the preset or do the copy and paste. When you save a cabinet model preset, it saves any microphone changes you made, including the microphone positions. You can also change the speakers. It doesn't save most of the mixer settings, so the volume and pan on the microphones is not going to be saved. I'll save this model preset. Click back to my original overall preset. You can see the microphones are back as they were and the speaker is back to Brit V2. Now I'll load the model preset. You'll notice the room microphones went back to their original position while all the other microphones went back to the saved model preset positions, and the blue speaker was restored. In the mixer, while it didn't keep the volume or pan, it did keep the 45-degree offset. Okay, that's it for this video. I am going to be using presets pretty heavily in my upcoming series on amps. See you there.